On Tuesday, I showed you how to approach drawing straight and clean lines inside of Photoshop. I also showed you how to use the ellipse template to do curves. Well, today I'm going to show you how to take those two techniques and to build a line work in this mechanical prop. But as a quick reminder, if you look below the post, you'll find links for free brushes and worksheets, as well as in-depth premium series available in the Ctrl+Paint store. So the brush that I'll be using for this entire process is a bit like a pen. It does have some pressure sensitivity on it, but you could use one that had pressure sensitivity turned completely off if you like, because for this type of line work, you're not going to want too much opacity jitter. So I like to begin by defining the outer contours. These are sort of the outlines of the shape. And I'm going to be doing a bit of draw through, where you draw beyond where you want to go to, just so you get that confident line. And then you can erase away where you don't want. But before I know where these lines end exactly, I'm going to need to define those ellipses. So I'm going to make a new layer. And I'll form an ellipse. And then I'll do the select, transform selection. And then I can actually get this ellipse right in place. And when I'm happy with it, I hit confirm. Go to edit, stroke. And from now on, I'll be using a keyboard shortcut to pull up the stroke menu. So you won't see me go to the edit menu anymore. So now I'm going to define the next contour here on its own layer, stroke. Okay, and I'm happy with the way those two live together, so I'll flatten them to a single layer. And then I'll go back down to that first layer where I made those original lines, and I'll erase away what I don't need. And then on a new layer, I'll define this back ellipse. Transform my selection. Confirm. Stroke. Erase away what I don't need. Okay, now I'm going to fast forward a bit and establish the rest of the primary contours. Now, generally speaking, I'm not a huge fan of time-lapse videos, but in this case, it's a lot of the same steps repeated over and over, but I think it can be useful to see how it is that I actually build this from start to finish. So this is sped up about 3 times, and I've also hidden the cursor, so all you're seeing is the results. And I've gone ahead and hidden my layer stack, but know that I'm not keeping very many layers at one time. I'm adding a few new ones, and then when I like them, I'll flatten them down. So on the face near the camera, I've got 2 cylindrical tubes that are nearly identical. One will be slightly smaller than the other, but there's really no sense in drawing both individually. So you'll see I'll draw the first one, so I'll duplicate the entire thing, and then move it over into correct perspective, and save myself a fair amount of time. Oftentimes, at the end of a cylinder, you have a slight bevel. What this means is that you're going to have 2 ellipses that are perfectly in parallel and very near one another. Usually what I like to do to save a little time is to draw one of these, usually the bigger one, and then duplicate it, shrink it slightly, and move it a little off center. And that way you don't have to define your ellipse twice, you just do it once and save yourself some time. And what I'm doing here, now that I've got my major anchors in place, is putting a little surface detailing in. For a last little bit of detailing here, I've decided to drop out of the time lapse and show you in real time. My goal here is to make the ribbing on the side of the cylinder. So instead of drawing it a bunch of times, I'm just going to draw it once, spend my time on it, and then duplicate it. So any sort of fine surface detailing that I'd want in each of these ribs, I'll draw on here. And I'll erase it a little bit just to soften it so it doesn't fight as much with the outer contour. I want this to be sort of low relief. Okay, and now that I'm happy with it, I'll duplicate it down the line, free transforming into perspective. So this is a great example of where you can let the computer do the work for you. Where I've drawn it once, And it's not especially creative to draw the same thing over and over again. So I'm going to let the computer sort of take over that burden for me. And then I'll flatten all those down together so they're on a single layer, and I'll erase away where I don't need them. And then I'll hide my underdrawing, and you'll see that what I'm left with is a particularly sharp drawing, nice and clean. So before I wrap up, I want to give a quick shout out to reader XRG. They watched Tuesday's video and saw that there was a feature I was not using, which is the transform selection command. This is a feature I've been wanting for years, and it turns out it was there all along. I just didn't know about it. So it really goes to show that there are just little things hidden in Photoshop that can change your process for the better. So thanks a lot, XRG. If anybody else has any interesting additions to this process, I'd love to hear about them. So put them in the comments. Thanks, guys.